Hey, what's good? What's good? What's good? What's good, Facebook family? What's good, YouTube family? Hey, you know how we do every single Wednesday. Welcome to Doc's Wisdom Wednesday. Hey, you know what I want to hit you with today is beliefs. What are you believing for? That's the question. What are you believing for? Because if you're not believing for anything, how can you receive anything? See, in my Bible, it says, ask, seek, knock. But see, when you ask for it and you start seeking it and you're knocking, are you believing? Are you believing that you have enough power in your tongue? And it says the power of life and death is in the tongue. Are you believing that you have enough power in your tongue to speak your life into existence the way you would like your life to be? What are you believing for? It's so crazy how we believe in so many different things, but we fail to believe in ourselves. See, I always talk about power and how important power is. Think about it. You have the power to believe whatever you choose to believe. You have the power to do, even though we don't think we can, whatever other people have done. I mean that. If someone else has done something that you believe or you say you want to do, why don't you believe that you can do it? See, before Roger Bannister broke the 4-minute mile in 1954, there was a belief that your heart would explode if anybody ran that fast. So no one could do it. After he did it, thousands of people have done it. High school students have done it. Because now they know it's possible because they've seen someone else do it. Their belief system changes. So what are you believing for? What are you believing without a doubt that you can bring into fruition? And understand, there will be doubt. But isn't it fun sometimes making the things happen that haters and people tell you can't happen? See, that's how I live my life. My life is built on when people tell me I can't do something, I got to make it happen just because I know it's possible because I watch other people do it. I remember when I used to, you know, drive down the street or I used to sit on the porch at my grandmother's house back when I was young and we would watch the cars go by. We would watch the tightest cars go by. We'd be like, oh, that's my car. Oh, that's my car right there. We would watch all these cars go by and we would dream that one day we would have those cars. See, when we were young, we believed that it could be possible. But what happened was we became older and we started to experience different situations that began to steal those dreams from us, to get us to think that it is impossible to still believe and do and have the things that we believed about when we were young. That's the trick of the enemy. Don't allow the enemy to steal two of the most valuable things you possess. Your time and your power. See, that time thing that the enemy tries to trick you out of, he's trying to get you to stay in the same place you're at. Because if you don't take the action to move forward and you continue to lament over what happened, what you did, and how you feel like you're not worthy, then he has you trapped. And time is continuing to go by. Even though you're trapped in the same situation that you know you're better than. Even though you're trapped in that same circumstance that you're capable of getting out of if you just believed. The other thing that the enemy tries to take away from you is your power. See, he would rather you be powerless. He would rather you believe that you don't have the power to move mountains, that you don't have the power to get out of that situation that unfortunately sometimes we place ourselves in and sometimes other people have placed us in. If he can get you to not believe that you have the power to get yourself out of it and he tricks you to think that you ran out of time and it's too late, then he's won. So don't allow the enemy to steal those two things, your time and your power. You have the power that you believe you have to get you into and out of any situation you would like. But you gotta believe it. All right, y'all, here we go. That's Doc's Wisdom Wednesday. I hope you continue to share this video. I thank you for all the comments, and let's try some. Comment below. What are the things that you're believing for that this day, that non-belief that you used to have, it stops, and now you're going to start believing that it's possible. So below, comment, help others. See, that's what we need to do. We need to encourage others to start saying, you know what? This is what I'm believing for in my life. So I'll start it off and I'll leave a comment below. But let's believe we can do great things because it's possible. Because you can live ordinary or you can live extraordinary. It's your choice. Peace.